Hi guys, this will be addressable system test 7. I know, 2 tests in a week, which is quite good, but I've had so much time, my hands have been grounded. I've done quite a bit down here. I showed in my last test that I've put up the new Roshni and the new KAC. Well, in this test, I'm going to show you something else I've done. I have put this call point up, connected to this IO. Now, I couldn't find the screws for the box. The box is usable, the box is fine. I could screw it up to the wall. It's just I couldn't find those screws to screw it on, so I've had to do it. I'll try and get the cover off now. Right, I've got the cover off. I've just done 2 screws into the wall from this plate. There's a fault because I cannot find the resistor for it. It could be anywhere in the world. Not literally. That's completely broken now. Oh well. Never mind. It's been connected to here. It's really, really shit, but I haven't put a cable tie around it and I can't be asked to walk up to my cable ties. The next biggest change is I've removed the Sigma because I don't need it. It was just space. I didn't really need it because I've got this now and I've set it to alert, so it does the same job as the other one did. And yeah, which it's down here and I'm going to take it up to my room later. So first test will be KAC, and then second test, third test, and then third test, and then smoke detectors. I have got loop 2 up and running again, but obviously still can't access the call point, just the 2 detectors. I will re-enable all sounders and I'll be back with you. Right, all sounders are re-enabled again. This video I'm going to try and have it so it's less than 10 minutes, so I've put it on TikTok as well, but I don't know. So all sounders are active. They're out of time massively for some stupid reason. First test. I'm gonna disable the Roshni because it's loud and obnoxious. Right, Roshni disabled. Do this call point if I find the key. There we go. Right, so I don't know if you've seen the last video that I may or may not have uploaded, but I have named them now. I'm going to make a video on what the names are and upload it and delete the other ones. I didn't do a very good job of it because I'd only just done it. Yeah, right, I'm just going to disable the buzzer. Right, buzzer disabled. Right, this will go alert. The LED doesn't light up for some odd reason, but this does. See, no LED. See, they're so out of time. No, obviously, because it's alert, it doesn't come up as a fire. So, ow! God. So, if we go to here, it's got IO, 1, middle, so middle of the shed, and then call point 4, middle of the shed. That's Dallas call point 4. What was it? Call point 1, all the way over there, call point 2, call point 3, call point 4. Very confusing. But it makes sense to me, so we'll give that a reset, and then we'll do some testing of smoke detectors and various detectors. I need to do heat at some point, but I haven't got anything to test it. We have a pre-alarm. There we go. Now obviously on this zone it's already been activated. I've turned activation on multiple zones on, but it won't work for some reason. Roshni goes off, but doesn't. But it is flashing. Well, we're over here. Test the two detectors here. Now, for some odd reason, that won't work. I got that working again! But it won't work again, so... Oh well, that beacon still works, the open area still works, it's just that one's being a dick. I'm gonna let them clear out, because for some odd reason, if you activate more than 5 detectors, the LEDs don't light up. It still sets off an alarm condition, but the LEDs don't light up, which defeats the object. This is really annoying. But call point LEDs still light up. I don't understand it. So I let them clear out so I can test both of them over there without having to come back. Even though you can't see one of the LEDs over there. Oh well. I'm back. Let's give it a reset. And then we'll go test loop 2. That should be fine. Or maybe not. Wow. Alright then, I'll play ball today. I will give it another 5 minutes or so. I'm back this time. I've just checked the analog values and I can actually reset it this time. But quick toilet break and I took my Sigma up to my room. And yeah, right, let's actually test loop 2 this time. I'm hoping to be able to get to that call point at some point, maybe in the future. But I don't know for sure. Obviously, when we rip down the shed, we will have to take everything out. And so, at that point, I will have to rip down all my fire alarm stuff, which is a bit annoying. Are you going to activate, or today, preferably? Nope. Usually it's anyone blast that one, it was quite good. There we go. Test the other one, obviously it won't create an alarm condition because it's dead. Fuck, I just dropped my vape and I have no idea where it's gone. Be back. Right, that was a right pain in the ass to try and get back, but I have it back now. This one requires quite a few blasts usually. If I could activate them from over here, I doubt it. There we go. That's activated. Yeah. But right. The other thing I forgot to show you guys at the start, something else I've programmed to do. So I finally worked out how to do it. Function button. I have a function button. And I've worked out how to use it. And I've set it to alert. I let those detectors clear out. And that's the end of the video. See you next time. Okay, maybe I was wrong. I'll fix that after the video though.